Hello, everybody. Just thought I'd jump on while I'm doing a little marbling this afternoon. Oh, wonder how I dipped without husband there. Oh, yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's a PVC pipe. So, kind of nice, then I can dip some all by myself. So, how is everybody this afternoon? Oh, from Germany. Awesome. Hello. So I took a scarf that I had marbled once before, and it turned out kind of light. It was a floral design, and I thought it would be kind of fun to try double marbling it. So I have several scarves that I'm wanting to do double marbling on. So, oh, from Fort Rip, Texas. Hi. Let's see, can I ask where you buy the ink? They're artist quality acrylics that I use. So brands such as Golden Fluid Acrylics or Utrecht or Jacquard. They just have to be artist quality and not the cheaper kind. Just gonna get a little paint on the edges here. Oh, Arizona, hello. You're in such a boring place compared to everyone else. Maryland, Miami, Kentucky, this is awesome. Wow, yeah, this is great. Well, thanks for jumping on. I don't normally jump on at this time. Thank you. I just thought I would, see, oh, hello, Australia, North Carolina, Netherlands. This is awesome. So I'm making silk scarves with water marbling, which is painting on water. Wow, we're hitting all over the country. This is great. North Carolina, Virginia. So just getting a little paint on the edges here. I'm in a newer studio, still kind of in the making right now. But so here, the fun thing about double marbling is it's always a fun surprise of how it's gonna turn out. So I don't know if you can really tell, but it's got more of a 3D effect when I do double marbling, and it always comes out super vibrant. Hello. Is it Australia, Canada, Georgia? This is great, awesome. So I'm just gonna give this a rinse here in some filtered water. It's just getting a little excess paint and thickened water off of it. And it's a 100% silk scarf that I work with. They're pre-treated in alum, and that's what helps the paint stick to the scarf. So normally in the evenings when I do lives, I have my husband here to help me hold it up. So hello from Sweden, awesome. I'm in Boise, Idaho. Indonesia, this is great. Okay, so I'm gonna try to kind of show this to you the best that I can. Like I said, normally I have another set of hands where I can open it up and show it to you better. So I'm gonna try to open it up here the best that I can so you can kind of see. So it had a light floral pattern on the background, and I just pre-treated it a second time and double marbled it. So then I just let it soak for a bit, hang it to dry. Let's say it from Ohio. In Greece, oh, this is awesome. Kansas, oh my goodness, Netherlands. I guess this was a good time to jump on. Since I'm in my new studio, I'm kind of set up where I can jump on at any time. So my goal is to jump on more often during the day. So let's see. Oh, finished product, yes. So we're not quite fully set up. So when I am, I'm gonna have more scarves showing so you can like see finished ones in the background. People really like to see the finished ones, so I'll try not to get it in the tray here. Let's see if I'm back here. Maybe I can show you a few. So somebody was asking to see some finished ones. So sky's the limit with designs that can be done. So you can see some are subtle and light, others are super vibrant. I just happen to have some that were layered up here so I could show you some different ones. So I do like every combination and design you can imagine. So a lot of people ask, you can't do images with this art form other than like hearts and flowers and circles, because the paints are always moving and flowing. But you can do any color combination, it all turns out great. How long do the colors last and stay vibrant? They stay looking like you can hand wash them over and over and over again. Hello from Italy. This is great. Yeah, let's see, just join. What are they? Silk scarves. Making silk scarves with water marbling. It's also known as painting on water. The traditional term is Ebru, E-B-R-U. And the paints are artist quality acrylics. I use a lot of Utrecht and Golden Heavy Body. Let's see, how do you keep the paint from washing out? Well, I pre-treat the scarves in alum, and it's a fixant or mordant that helps the paint adhere to the scarf, and it just soaks right into it instead of just staying on top, so they can be hand washed over and over again. Let's see. Oh, thank you. That was very sweet of you. So I'm just gonna get the top of this. You can see that paints have fallen to the bottom, but that's okay. I just have to clean the surface. Get all the excess paint off of the top. Can I buy the scarf that you made right now? Yeah, you sure can. That one is, if you go under, well, my website is blueivymarbling.com. If you go under shop scarves, you can see TikTok live scarf number one, and you can purchase it there. So see, I'm taking this excess paint off of the surface. So it takes a few times to go over it, because if there's anything left on the surface, then it'll get onto the next scarf. From Fiji, hello. See, there's still quite a bit of pink on there, and I don't want that to get on the next one. So I have to, and I did layer, sometimes if I put the paints on heavier, then it takes a little bit more. So sometimes it could take even like 4 or 5 times of just running over the water. But since I was laying that pink on pretty heavy, I still have a fair amount there, so it's gonna take a couple more times. So I'm gonna do another double marbled scarf, so I'll show you what it looks like beforehand, and then I'll show you how it looks afterwards. Hello, Greece. Yeah, no help from the hubby. Normally my husband is on here. We jump on Mondays and Thursdays at 7 Central. So it's great because he's reading your comments and I'm painting while we're talking and having fun. But he's at work during the day, and I finally have a contact in my eye where I can actually read. So hello, UK. So I think I'm ready here. Pretty clean now. So I'm gonna go on to the next one. So this is the next scarf. I want a double marble. So sometimes when I don't super love it the first time around, then I'll go back and double marble it. So this is where we're starting from. and you'll see it's gonna turn out completely different. Oh, I'm glad that you joined. First time watching. So I was just sharing that normally my husband and I jump on Mondays and Thursdays at 7 Central. But I'm trying it on my own during the day now. So, okay, so I just showed you we're double marbling. So I'm gonna, a lot of people ask, do you plan it all out? Not always. Right now I actually don't have it planned. I'm just kind of winging it. But double marbling is so fun because when I'm just marbling a scarf one time, I have a really good idea because the scarf turns out just the way that you see it on top of the water. But when I double marble it, it turns out completely different. And I don't know what it's gonna look like till I take it off the water. So, oh, let's see. It is 2:30 where I'm at in Boise, Idaho. Sierra Leone. I'm not sure where that is. I'll have to look that up. So I'd start, oh, hello in Scotland, New York, England. Oh my goodness, we are hitting all over the place. Kenya, this is awesome. Mississippi, Vegas, wow, Belgium, Sweden, Texas, Puerto Rico, Netherlands, Greece. We're hitting all over the world right now. This is so exciting. I don't usually do this on my own. So, Illinois, that's where I'm from. Michigan, South Africa, New Zealand. This is incredible. Well, thanks for stopping, everybody. You guys are awesome. And thanks for commenting too. This is so fun seeing where everybody's from. So it's a little deceiving that there's this pink underneath because right now it looks like there's going to be pink in the scarf, but there won't be until I'm going to add some in. But right now I've just got white and green on the surface. So if anybody is interested in buying any of my silk scarves, my website is blueivymarbling.com. That's blueivymarbling.com. The paints are artist quality acrylics. Utrecht, Golden, Jacquard. So they just have to be a high quality acrylic in order to work, in order to have the paints come out nice and vibrant. So thanks for joining in. We are double marbling silk scarf. Hello. No, it doesn't smell like chemicals at all. It's just regular artist quality acrylics. So I'm trying to kind of read as I go. Hello, Netherlands. Okay, this time I'm just gonna go for some hearts. Because there's a little bit of hearts in the original design. So, yeah, and oh, is this like the things you see? I have seen people dip shoes, like canvas gym shoes. And the water is thickened with carrageenan. It's a seaweed extract. Let's see. Oh yes, I will show you some finished products. So I'm in a new studio for me and just recently moved. So I'm kind of in the process of setting up still. But I am going to have finished products hanging in the background because a lot of people like to see those as I'm painting. Those that are just jumping on, I'm always on Mondays and Thursdays, 7 Central. At that time, my husband gets on with me and he is answering questions while I'm painting. So we have a lot of fun with it. Been doing that for a couple years now. I've been doing this art form, a lot of people ask, for over about 11 years now. And my business is, let's see, about 8 years old. So, oh, thank you. So I'll show you again that I'm doing a double marble here. So this is the first time around. So it's gonna turn out totally different when I do this second time of marbling. So just takes me a second here to attach the scarf to this device that I have made out of PVC pipe. That way I'm able to, because the scarf has to be laid down on the water very evenly, because if it doesn't go down in one like nice continuous motion, then it'll mess up the design. So I've got this PVC pipe that I made the same size as my tray. So, okay, now I can show you. So I've got my scarf connected here. That way I don't need a second set of hands to lay this down. So once it starts to touch the water, you have to keep going and not stop or else it will leave a mark. Yeah, that's this PVC pipe has come in handy. This is great that I don't always have to wait for help. So just gotta get it unclipped and sometimes it's a little tricky keeping it all resting on there. I do training. I have a course that I created that walks you through every little step of learning this process. So I do have that as one option. And then I also will do live Zoom training. So I do it in a class session, like if several people want to do it all at one time, or I do individual via Zoom. I stick a little paper towel in the clips so they don't get paint on something else. Grab my gloves. So yeah, this is double marbling. Oh, price, most of my scarves are $65. So I get a little paint on the edges so that it just blends in. If anybody is interested in this particular scarf, you can go on the website, blueivymarbling.com, shop scarves, and you'll see TikTok Live scarf number 2. So this is the second one. So we'll see. Always a surprise with the double marbling. It makes a super cool 3D effect. I don't know how well you can really see it. But yeah, it's really cool because it's a design on top of a design. So then I just give it a rinse here in some filtered water. I think this one looks really tropical. Very fun and colorful. So just a quick rinse to get the excess paint and sizing off of it. So I'll try to show you this the best that I can. Eventually, I'd like to have some clothesline so that I could just hang this up right afterwards. But usually my husband's here to help me hold it up so I can show you. So I'll do my best to give you an idea here. So hopefully you can kind of see there. Yes, I do get paint on myself all the time and like everything around me too. It gets a little messy, but it's fun. Yeah, it's a fun process. Always a surprise. It never gets boring. An exotic cocktail. I like that. Okay, so we just get the surface cleaned off. This part just takes a minute. A cancer ribbon on one. I have done cancer ribbons in the color, in different colors that are needed. So I've done a breast cancer one and autism and yeah, several different ones. So yes, I can do that. And then, oh, if you're interested in a custom order, I do have a listing under shop scarves. You'll see custom scarves. And there you can choose the design and colors that you would like. So this just kind of gathers the excess paint, the bulk of it, and then I run over with paper towels. Okay, oh, they run $65. That's where most of them are at. Let's see. When rinsing, it doesn't bleed because the scarves are pre-treated in alum. And that is a fixant or mordant that helps the paint adhere right into the scarf. So it's set once that dry scarf touches the water. And thanks for those that are helping answer questions while I keep working here. So we're making silk scarves, but thank you so much for helping answer the questions. Let's see, how do you make a note on the site? When you You just add the item to your cart, and then there's a place for notes where you can leave me a message. And if for some reason you don't find that, you can just email me and I'll get it, blueivymarbling@gmail.com. Yes, it is safe to drain because the sizing that the water is mixed with, it's carrageenan, so it's a natural seaweed extract. So is it possible to do a cotton scarf? Can be done, yes. I only have cotton bandanas. I don't actually have cotton scarves myself, but cotton scarves can be done. Hello. Okay, I think I've got most of the paint off here. Just gotta double check it. Oh, thank you. Let's see. Oh, I'm loving my new spot. Let's see, just a tiny bit on there. I love it so much. I'm getting it all organized and it's a lot more functional than what I've been in. So we've got a little more work to do to dress it up, but I'm so excited. So I feel like it just enables me to jump on a lot easier than where I've been. So that's why I'm here right now. Oh, the acrylic paints, they're watered down because I use heavy body acrylics. So yes, they're just thin down with water and sometimes a little surfactant. So preparing paints is the hardest part of water marbling. So, and there is a paint that I could recommend that they make already prepared paints. So if you're just getting started, that makes it a lot easier. So yes, I will be displaying the scarves in the back so you can see different ones. Let's see, I do not put vinegar in the water. It's just water and I don't know if you mean the rinse water or in this water, but I don't put it in either one. I used to have to put it in the water when I used methacel, but now I use carrageenan, so you don't need vinegar. So yeah, and I'm always happy to answer questions. I love sharing this art form. So I'm happy to help out as much as I can. Okay, let's see. I got one more that I'm gonna double marble. So I think this will be a fun one to try. So I'm gonna double marble this scarf. There was a part of it that I wasn't thrilled with how, okay, this is why. Try not to get it in the water. So some of the edge on this the first time didn't come out all that great. So that's why I wanted to double marble it. Let's see, is the water always red? No, it's not. It actually starts off completely clear, but the first scarf that I just made on this live had a lot of heavy pink in it. So that fell to the bottom. So that's what you're seeing there. So I'm gonna pull out some of these colors and double marble the scarf. So for those that are just joining us, I'm having fun doing some double marbling. You never know how it's gonna turn out because it's, when you're just marbling a scarf just one single time, it ends up looking exactly like the paints do on the water. But then when you double marble it, it comes out completely different. So it gives a really cool 3D effect. So I'm just pulling out the colors that I want to do that are in this scarf. So I think that's it. Let's see. You've never seen this before. This is The Ancient Art of Ebru, E-B-R-U. It's also called water marbling. So it's a very old Turkish art form that's been around for centuries. How much water with the acrylic? Very small amount. A lot of the paints I do three parts water to one part paint. But each paint has to be treated individually and you have to keep testing it on the water until you get it to work just right. So that is the hardest part of water marbling, is preparing the paints. Yes, the balance is difficult, but so worth it. Yes, once you get figure out the preparing the paint part, then it's so much fun. Yes, it's mostly water and paint most of the time for me. But once in a while, I'll have to add a little surfactant, which there's different things that you can use for surfactant. I use Dawn Liquid Ultra Concentrated Dish Soap. I'm not sure where my bottle is on that. I can let you know if you want to know exactly. I'm not sure where my bottle is right now because I don't use it all that often. I used to have to use it more when my sizing, I used Methocel, but with carrageenan, I have not had to use surfactant very much. So most of my paints are just the paint and water. Oh, thank you. I'm trying to answer some of your questions while I keep painting. So what other tools do I use? I have some rakes that I've made. Like, this is a single rake. It's made out of wood and nails. This is a double rake. So two rows of nails that are alternating, and then this comb is made out of 3-inch needles, and then I use a stylus. I've got different thicknesses of styluses. I've also got traditional Ebru brushes, so quite a few different things. Oh, thank you. Yes, it's a lot of fun. So I'm trying a little bit of double marbling today. So much fun because the end result is a big surprise. Oh, number two gifter badge. Awesome. Thank you so much. trying to glance. How much time does a painting usually take? Anywhere from about 10 minutes to 40 minutes. So some of my floral designs that I do take quite a bit of time because I get pretty detailed. Yes, they are hand washable. This one's gonna be super vibrant. So no, this is not a custom order. This one, I'm just having fun. I had some scarves that I wanted to double marble. So that's what this one is. And I'll show you in just a second. The scarf that we're double marbling. If anybody is interested in this scarf, you can grab it on the website, blueivymarbling.com, and go under Shop Scarves, and you'll see TikTok Live Scarf number 3. You can grab it that way. Okay, so I'm gonna grab the scarf that, this is the scarf that I'm double marbling. So, always a fun surprise because I don't know how it's gonna turn out. So I'm just getting this hooked up to my PVC pipe contraption here so I can lay it down myself. Okay, so we've got it all connected here. So this is the tricky part, just lining it up. Thanks for jumping on. Oh, somebody's joining me here. Hi. I'm on a live. To blend it in. Okay, again, this is TikTok Live Scarf number 3, if anybody is interested in it. So you've never seen this before. This is water marbling. You've never seen me use the traditional Ebru brushes. I used them on a live, I don't know, maybe a week or two ago, but I'll definitely pull them out. They're 65. Okay, so I'll show you here. Oh, wow. These are so fun, the double marbling. I just love it because they are just so truly unique and they have such a cool 3D effect. And look at how vibrant that is. I love the teal in there. So yeah, I get excited. I've been doing this for over 11 years now, and I still get super excited because it's just fun. Okay, so I'm gonna give this a quick rinse and then I'll try to show you. As best I can here. So these are 100% silk and they are hand washable. Just hang it to air dry. Okay. So I'm gonna try to show this to you. And again, I'm always on Mondays and Thursdays, 7 Central. My husband jumps on with me and he helps answer. He reads me everybody's questions and we talk and we have fun. And that way I can be marbling while he's reading. So it works out well that way. So trying to give you an idea there as best I can. So, all right. Well, thanks for joining me this afternoon. So it's kind of new for me to be jumping on by myself, but, how can you order? My website is blueivymarbling.com. That particular scarf was TikTok Live scarf number 3, if you're interested in that one. They're one of a kind, so you have to grab it. I can't duplicate it. Molly's on here. Yes, you're going to see my kid this weekend. I'm so excited for you guys. So thanks again, everybody, for jumping on. This has been fun. I'm going to try and jump on again tomorrow during the day in the afternoon. So thanks, everybody. We'll see you soon.